Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Newport Mansions. I'm standing in front of the Marble House. This spectacular building was completed in just 4 years. Construction began in 1888, and it was completely finished in 1892. It was built for William Kay and Alva Vanderbilt, and it is one of the most opulent, beautiful buildings of this famous Gilded Age era, one of 11 that the Preservation Society of Newport County interprets and opens to the public. Richard Morris Hunt, known as the Dean of American Architecture, was chosen by the Vanderbilts to design this beautiful marble palace. The exterior of the house is Tuckahoe marble from New York, and when you step inside, it literally will take your breath away. The entry hall is you're surrounded by warm yellow sienna marble. The dining room is pink Numidian marble from northern Africa. All told, there is 500,000 cubic feet of marble in this house. Richard Morris Hunt designed the house as a perfect cube, and when you step into that the entry hall, you're in the center of the cube. He designed it after the Petit Trianon. So please join me in Marble House and celebrate the season, Christmas in Newport and at the Newport Mansions. It's an experience that you and your family will never forget. Come in, join me. We have musical groups, we have ballerinas, we have choirs. You step in to the grand hall in the Marble House. This is the entrance. This is the yellow sienna marble from Italy, and you can see we have visitors in all of the rooms, the gold room appropriately. Tissue-sized gold leaf makes up that gold room. A dinner at the Vanderbilts during the Gilded Age was an event. You would sit down to dinner with a footman with powdered wigs and high-heeled breeches that would assist you to and from the table because those chairs weigh 75 to 100 pounds. You can just picture yourself sitting down and dining and first talking the first course to the person on your left, and the second course you would speak to the person on your right, and you would continue this very proper etiquette through this 4 to 5 hour dinner. And you're looking at the portrait of Alva Vanderbilt. She was born in Mobile, Alabama in 1853, and her father was a cotton merchant. And after the Civil War, he decided to move his wife and 3 daughters to France. And Alva went to the finest finishing schools in France, and this is where she fell in love with everything French. And truly, the house that she designed, along with the architect Richard Morris Hunt, it is an encyclopedia of French design. Well, this concludes your evening at Marble House, and I think when you walk through the front doors of this beautiful, opulent house that was built for the Vanderbilts, William Kay and Alva, you step into the front entrance and you get a feeling of what it was like to be a part of the Gilded Age. You can picture Alva Vanderbilt sweeping down the staircase, but just for a moment, stop and think of yourself walking down that staircase in a grand ensemble from Paris, France, that was made just for you for the Newport season. They would come to their cottage in Newport, as they like to call them here in Newport. These grand houses are actually cottages for only 8 to 10 weeks. The summer season began in the middle of July, and it would extend through the end of September. And then they would pack everything up, close the house up for the season, and return to their home in New York, leaving behind magical memories that they had created here for all of us to enjoy when we read about Alva and William Kay and how they entertained hundreds of people. Bellevue Avenue in Newport, Rhode Island, and all of the historic houses here are something to see. Don't miss Marble House. Don't miss the opportunity to step through the front door and feel like you're a part of an era that will never be repeated again. Thank you for coming. Please enjoy.